Decoded is an education company, and we're passionate about teaching anyone and everyone about the technologies behind the screen. Quite famous for code in a day, we can teach anyone about these things in a very short period of time. So I find it really hard to kind of think about leadership, because there are so many leaders within our business, but we're all driven by the same goals and the same vision and the same mission. Being part of this startup community, surrounded by lots of CEOs of businesses with very, very big visions and missions, there's a real belief that in the power of technology to transform not only kind of individuals, but potentially the world. And the leaders of those businesses are very much not just driven by the growth or financial success of themselves or that business. There's a real sense of being on a mission and having a vision, and how important the culture of that is to a small team, and often very small because it doesn't need to be big. When I was launching the company with my male co-founders, I wasn't thinking about gender. I was thinking, we have a mission impossible that we have to solve. Could you actually take someone who knows nothing about technology on such a radical journey in a day that they actually feel that they could master that art? But it was only through teaching a lot of women. So over 50% of the people that we've taught at Decoded are female. There is a desire to learn about the technologies behind the screen, but there is a common myth, and I hear it a lot, that women, women's minds don't work that way. So it was very interesting to analyze the difference between men and women and their ability to think computationally. There's absolutely no difference. But there is a radical difference when it comes to the confidence and belief that actually this is something that you could be good at or be a part of. And there does seem to be a real wave, I think, of female entrepreneurship beginning to kind of bubble through. I've learned so much from Richard Ross, from Moo, my partner, Michael Acton Smith, Mind Candy, right through to actually really small kind of startups and individual coders as well. You know, I was very inspired by a 15-year-old coder that I met recently, just finding out about how he was learning, how he'd been teaching himself since he was 8 years old. I think mentorship's a very, very big topic at the moment. A lot of people are looking for mentors. But I think you can find mentorship in lots of different shapes and sizes. And it's quite a reciprocal relationship as well. I think you're learning from people all the time about how you do things, and hopefully giving them something back too. My advice to future business leaders or future entrepreneurs or anyone who's got that fire in their belly about really wanting to do something greater: there are incredible incubators, loads of online resources about how to get started and how to raise finance, how to put together a business model, but ultimately, just do it. Because you can think about it for years, but it's taking that leap. It's going from saying, I'm thinking, saying, I am. And suddenly the world responds to you very differently when you put out a message of actually being that business. So it's a really exciting roller coaster journey. It's not easy, but I can't think of anything better, really.